past, my science classes have always been very hands-on. And so I've done a lot of activities with them and sometimes even given them a choice. But this was much more open-ended, tied directly to a real-world problem. This science PBL just fits, having real-world problems that they can do. To a parent, project-based learning, I would start with the authenticity, that it's a real-world question that is the basis for this project. And along the way, they're going to try to solve this question in ways that make sense to them.
Like, it could be a project where we all have to be in groups and just have to do a post-it, but I like how we can really choose what we want to do.
The bee thing I didn't know at all, so it would be a chance for people to know that they should change something to save the bees.
There was a lot of growth that took place for me teaching during this project. My expectations are pretty high and they work to exceed those. So for me to continue to have high expectations, I have to have those high expectations of myself as well. So growth comes with that.
I think like you'll try and search up like just one specific detail, and in the end you come out with like just many more, like more than you expected, and you just like grow so much.
My number one goal at the beginning was to follow it through, to not cancel it at any point, and to create an atmosphere that allowed for the craziness and for me to learn, meet with every group as often as possible, to give them as many resources as I could, whether I created a blend space for some website so they didn't have to just search some books, some articles, but I wanted to see what they could do.
She had a lot of books in her classroom about bees that she got from the library, and also she had articles and computers so we could look stuff up on the computer.
The engagement was sky high. It was much more than when I create the lab, that we all do the same lab, that we all do the same thing. Given the choice, I was very nervous that they wouldn't engage, but the majority of them, it was amazing. Even at lunch recess, you'd walk around thinking it's gonna be crazy. Oh no, they were all totally into their projects up and down the hallway. The surprises to me were their interest level in sticking through it. They rose to the occasion. They really did top-notch work. They did the research. They knew their research. If they were asked questions, they were able to defend them. So they really did rise to the occasion.
It's like a fun, energetic way of learning and like coming out with more than you expected. Yeah, you have to like think outside the box.
Project-based learning will lead into ownership because they made all the choices along the way. From I provided the resources, but they chose which ones they're going to use. They chose the type of project. By having to present it to a real audience, that's something they'll have to do in the future.
I would love to do another class, like social studies, and math would be the best.
There are approximately 8 groups that want to change something here at Independence. So we still have to work on those things, but those are gonna be something real that they could possibly impact. And I think if they see that happen, that'll be even more impressive that I did that.
So in the spring, we are trying to plant a garden that'll help attract bees and to help the population grow.
And we might ask some of our classmates to volunteer to help us with the garden that we're going to do in the spring.
Every year I try something new because I want to grow as a teacher.